Hi students, all of you, good morning and good evening. Welcome to my class. In the last class, we are discussing the preparation of phenols. And we discussed three reactions. The first one is from chlorobenzene. Second one is from, yes, the second one is from benzene diazonium salt. And the third one is from, can anybody text what are the three reactions we studied in the last class? Yes, on the screen, you can see on the screen. Once again, the previous three reactions, what we studied in the last class, I'm going to share you on the screen. Yes, here you can see the last three reactions we studied about the preparation of phenols. Once again, I'm just recalling for 2 minutes. So this is the first reaction, preparation of phenol from chlorobenzene. Once observe the reaction, preparation of phenol from chlorobenzene. Yes, that reaction is an example of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Conversion of chlorobenzene into phenol, the reaction is an example of nucleophilic substitution reaction, right? Just a minute. Just a minute. Right, very good. So this is the first reaction we studied in the last class, and some CET problems and PU level questions are also studied. Take the screenshot if you are not taken the screenshot in the yesterday's class. Okay. And the second reaction is preparation of phenol from benzene sulfonic acid. Benzene sulfonic acid, this is the benzene sulfonic acid. See here, this is the benzene sulfonic acid. When the benzene sulfonic acid is heated with sodium hydroxide and then reacted with acid, then we are getting the phenol. So this is also completed in the last class. And the next reaction is from benzene diazonium salt. This one is also completed. And this reaction particularly, conversion of aniline, this is the aniline. Conversion of aniline into benzene diazonium halide. The reaction is called as diazotization reaction. This is a named reaction important for PU level. Remember this one. What is the diazotization reaction? When first degree aromatic amines are going to react with a mixture of sodium nitrite and hydrochloric acid at a temperature of 0 to 5 degrees Celsius, then the benzene is going to be diazotized. What is the diazonium group means? Single bond N2 plus group is the diazonium group, right? So from this benzene diazonium chloride, now here we are taking this benzene diazonium chloride as the reactant, and that is heated with warm water. Then the diazonium group, N2 plus group, is replaced with OH group, right? So all these reactions are studied in the last class. Now it is the reaction about preparation of phenol from cumin. Preparation of phenol from cumin. See this one, this is the cumin. On the benzene ring, which group is present? CH3, single bond, CH, single bond, CH3. Yes, what is the name of this group? Isopropyl group. Once again, the group is called as isopropyl group. Single bond CH, on the left side CH3, on the right side CH3, this group is called as isopropyl group. So the compound is called as cumin or isopropyl benzene. Write down the word. Isopropyl benzene. Right here, I'm rearranging the groups. CH single bond CH3, single bond CH3. Now this is the cumin is undergoing oxidation in the presence of air. In the presence of air means it is the self-oxidation reaction. Self-oxidation reaction. What is undergoing? Cumin is undergoing self-oxidation reaction in the presence of air. Then here you see the product. Cumin hydroperoxide. I'm going to write on the board. So the concept is a preparation of phenol from cumin. Cumin means on the benzene ring, isopropyl group. Isopropyl group means single bond CH, single bond CH3, single bond CH3. This is the isopropyl group. So the compound is called as isopropyl benzene, also called as cumene. Now it is undergoing oxidation in presence of atmospheric air. Between this carbon and hydrogen, these two oxygens are going to be added. Then we can write the product, benzene ring, single bond C. Here I am writing the CH3 group and the second CH3 group. This is a carbon and hydrogen. Between this carbon and hydrogen, two oxygens are added. If you observe the bond here, single bond O, single bond O, single bond. Between the two oxygen atoms, a single bond is present. This bond is called as peroxy bond. Once again, the single bond between two oxygen atoms, this single bond is called as peroxy bond. Now this compound is coming from cumene and it is having a peroxy group. The compound is named as cumene hydroperoxide. Cumene hydroperoxide. Now this cumene hydroperoxide is reacted with an acid. Between the benzene carbon and this carbon, this bond is going to be delocalized. Between carbon and oxygen, this bond is going to get shifted towards this oxygen. Now observe this group. Here the oxygen is going to get sigma bonded electrons. Then this OH group becomes as OH minus. OH minus. And here between this carbon and this carbon, the sigma bonded electrons are shifting between this carbon and this oxygen. Here single bond becomes double bond. Between this carbon, bond is going to be broken. That means electrons are going to be lost. Then this carbon gets positive charge. Here OH group oxygen is going to have negative charge. That means this OH group is going to attack at this carbon to get the phenol. Benzene ring, single bond, OH. So here the bond is broken. This OH group is going to get attack at this carbon. Then we get the phenol. And finally, this is the remaining CH3, single bond C, single bond CH3. Here single bond becomes double bond. So the byproduct is, what will be the byproduct? The byproduct is CH3, single bond C, double bond O, single bond CH3. So the main product is phenol and the byproduct is, yes, can anybody text? What is this byproduct? CH3, single bond C, double bond O, single bond CH3. What is the byproduct? What is the name of the byproduct? Just waiting for your answer. I'm asking about this one. CH3, single bond C, double bond O, single bond CH3. Dimethyl ether. Chiranth. Dimethyl ether. Chiranth, what is meant by ether group? What is meant by ether group? This is the ether group. Single bond O, single bond is the ether group. If it is having CH3 and CH3, now this is called as dimethyl ether. Dimethyl ether. This is not dimethyl ether. Yes, very good. Who's that one? Sushma. Propanone. Three carbons are present here. Three carbons means prop. Between carbon and carbon, single bond is present. N. Single bond C, double bond O, single bond. This group is called as ketone. Ketones are called as ON. So the compound is named as propanone, right? Okay. Propanone is the IUPAC name. What is its common name? What is the common name of propanone? In the first PUC also you studied the common name of propanone, right? Very good. The common name of propanone is, yes, just a minute. Just a minute, please. Yes, the common name of propanone is acetone. Acetone, right? So in this reaction, what we are doing? Isopropyl benzene, which is known as cumene, is subjected to auto-oxidation in the presence of atmospheric air. Then it is giving the cumene hydroperoxide. The cumene hydroperoxide is reacted in presence of an acid, gives phenol as the main product and propanone, or that is known as acetone, as the byproducts. Take the screenshot. And this reaction is important for either 1 mark or 2 marks. The question is asked as, write the preparation of phenol from cumene. The question is, write the preparation of phenol from cumene. So, okay, This is all about preparation of phenol from benzene derivatives. We are preparing the phenol from benzene derivatives. Right, now it is about physical properties. Physical properties. Yes, can anybody say some examples of physical properties? Can anybody say some examples for physical properties? Melting points, boiling points, densities, colors, solubility, all these are the physical properties. Right, here we are discussing two physical properties. The first one is boiling points. The first physical property discussed is boiling points. Yes, I am considering two compounds, three compounds I am going to consider: alcohols, phenols, and ethers. Alcohols means R single bond, O single bond, H. Phenols means AR means benzene ring. AR means benzene ring, single bond O, single bond H. These are the phenols. Ethers means R single bond, O single bond, R. Yes. All of us know about the formation of hydrogen bonding. In the first phase, we studied the formation of hydrogen bonding. The hydrogen bondings are classified into two types: intermolecular hydrogen bonding and intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Whenever oxygen is going to be bonded with hydrogen, here oxygen is going to have partial negative charge, hydrogen is going to have partial positive charge. So between the oxygen and hydrogen, when partial negative and partial positive charges are there on the oxygen and hydrogen, this can form intermolecular hydrogen bondings. Of course, this one also can form intermolecular hydrogen bondings, because oxygen is going to have partial negative charge, hydrogen is going to have partial positive charge. So these two compounds, alcohols and phenols, are able to form intermolecular hydrogen bondings. Such compounds are going to have high boiling points. One of the consequence of intermolecular hydrogen bonding is high boiling points. So alcohols and phenols are going to have high boiling points with compared to ethers, right? So I'm going to take some examples. I'm taking a simple example, that is alcohol, methanol formula: CH3 single bond, O single bond, H, right? This is the methanol. And I'm taking the water molecule. Suppose I'm going to write like this: oxygen is having partial negative charge, hydrogen is having partial positive charge. Here oxygen is having partial negative charge, hydrogen is having partial positive charge. Between this oxygen and this oxygen, just a minute, I'm going to rearrange the compound little bit. Rearrangement: oxygen single bond, hydrogen single bond, hydrogen, hydrogen with partial positive charge, oxygen with partial negative charge. This is a methanol and it is a water molecule. Yes, you can guess now. What you can guess? There is a intermolecular hydrogen bonding is present between oxygen of methanol to hydrogen of water molecule. Here also, between the oxygen of water molecule to hydrogen of methanol, what is going to be formed? Intermolecular hydrogen bonding is going to be formed. As a result, the methanol is soluble in water. Because of the formation of intermolecular hydrogen bonding, methanol is soluble in water. But here we are not saying about the solubility first. First we are going to discuss the boiling point. Boiling point is a physical property. Physical properties depends upon molar mass. As the molar mass increases, the melting and boiling points also increases. Right, I am taking the four examples. The first example is methanol. Second one is ethanol. third one is propanol, and the fourth one is butanol. Butanol. I am not saying whether it is a 1-butanol or 2-butanol, because butanol can form two types of compounds, 1-butanol and 2-butanol. Suppose I am saying this is the 1-butanol, 1-butanol. Yes, methanol formula CH3OH, ethanol formula CH3CH2OH, propanol formula CH3CH2CH2OH. 1-butanol is written as CH3CH2CH2CH2OH. Yes, based on these formulas, we can say that what is going to get increased? Molar mass is going to get increased. So whenever the molar mass is going to get increased, the boiling points are going to get increased. So finally, we can say that among the methanol, ethanol, propanol, and 1-butanol, which is going to have high boiling point? Among these compounds, which one is going to have high boiling point? Text me your answer. Yes, very good. So among all these compounds, 1-butanol is going to have the high boiling point. What is the reason? Why 1-butanol is having high boiling point among these compounds? What is the reason? Text me your answer. What is the reason for the high boiling point of 1-butanol? Very good. Right. Because of its high molecular mass. Because of its high molecular mass, among these compounds, 1-butanol is going to have high boiling point. So simply we can say that boiling point is directly proportional to mm. What is meant by mm? Molar mass. Take the screenshot. Yes, my dear students, here I am saying about butanol. Suppose I am going to take the butanol. Just a minute. I am going to consider the butanol now. What is the formula of butanol? Text me the formula of butanol. What is the formula of butanol? Just text me. What is the formula of butanol? The formula of butanol is C4H9OH. C4H9OH. It is going to form two isomers. Butanol is going to form two isomers. One is CH3CH2CH2CH2OH. This is one compound. And the second compound is CH3CH single bond OH, single bond CH2, single bond CH3. Yes, text me the names. What are the names of these two compounds? The first compound is called as one butanol. The second compound is called as 2-butanol. Already we completed the IUPAC nomenclature. Now guess among the 1-butanol and 2-butanol whether both are having the same boiling point or they are going to have different boiling point. Actually, I am saying that boiling point is depending upon molar mass. Once again, the boiling point is depending upon molar mass. Here, in the case of 1-butanol and 2-butanol, the molecular formula is the same. When the molecular formula is same, molar mass is also same. So whenever the molar mass is same, whether the boiling points are going to be same or not. Just text me. Whether the boiling points are going to be same or not. The boiling points are going to be different. Different. Why? Because means here all the four carbons are in the chain and the OH group is present at first carbon. Here the OH group is present at second carbon. This is acting as a branch. Here the OH group is acting as a branch. Whenever branches increases in a molecule for the given formula, whenever the branches increases, the boiling points of the compounds get decreases. So because of that reason, butanol is going to have lesser boiling point than 1-butanol. Write down the statement. For the given same molecular formula, the statement is, for the given same molecular formula, when the number of branches increases, the boiling point of the compounds get decreases. Right, if you are having the NCERT textbook, there you can see one example. I'm going to share the example to you from the NCERT textbook. One example about boiling points. Yes, from the NCERT textbook, if you follow the in-text questions, see here, in-text questions. These in-text questions will be asked in the CET and in NEET. Whoever the student want to get a best score in the CET or NEET, it's enough to complete the in-text questions and example problems. Anyway, I'm going to show you the example problem. Boiling points of alcohols. Just a minute. I'll show you the example. Yes, see here, this is the example. Example 11.3. Example 11.3. Read the question. Those who are not having the textbook, take the screenshot of that question. Take the screenshot. Read the question properly. Arrange the following set of compounds in the order of their increasing boiling points. Right? Once again, I'm going to share one more screen to you. Yes, just a minute, it will be opened. Yes, just a minute, yes, right. So example 11.3, in that question, what were given? Pentane on all is written as CH3, CH2, 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 OH. Second one, butane on all, CH3, CH2, 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 OH. Next one, butane 2-ol, CH3, CH single bond OH, CH2, CH3. Next one, ethanol, CH3, CH2, OH. Next one, propane 1-ol, CH3, CH2, CH2, OH. And lastly, methanol, CH3, OH. So all these are the compounds given in the question, and we have to arrange these compounds in the increasing order of their boiling points. We had to arrange these compounds in the increasing order of their boiling points. Already I said that boiling points are depending upon, the boiling points are depending upon molar mass. So among all these compounds, which one is having the low molar mass? Methanol is having the low molar mass. Methanol. See the molecular formula of methanol? CH3OH. Here only one carbon is there, right? Whereas in the ethanol, two carbons are there. In the propanol, three carbons are there. In the butanol, four carbons are there, but butanol is of two types. Butane 2-ol is there, butane 1-ol is there, and lastly it is the pentanol or pentane 1-ol. Yes, the alcohol which is having the less molar mass is going to have low boiling point. Once again, the alcohol which is having the low molar mass is going to have less boiling point. As a result, methanol is having, on the screen, see on the screen, methanol is having lesser boiling point than ethanol. Ethanol is having lesser boiling point than propanol. Actually here propanol is given as propane 1-ol, right? Next, butane 2-ol is having lesser boiling point than butane 1-ol. What is the reason? Text me your answer. Butane 2-ol, this is second carbon. This is the second carbon. Second carbon having the OH. So this is a compound butane 2-ol, whereas OH group is present at first carbon and it is a butane 1-ol. So among the butane 2-ol and butane 1-ol, butane 2-ol is having the lesser boiling point than butane 1-ol. What is the reason? Yes, very good, very good. So whenever two compounds are there, this is one compound, this is one compound, this is another compound. Whenever two compounds are there with same molecular formula, means isomers, isomers. So whenever the isomers are there, when the number of branches get increases, the boiling points get decreases. As a result, butane-2-ol is having lesser boiling point than butane-1-ol. And lastly, pentane-1-ol. Pentane-1-ol is having high molar mass among all these compounds. Hence, pentane-1-ol is having relatively high boiling point among all these compounds. Right? Take the screenshot of this one. Take the screenshot. This is the order of boiling points of the given compounds. So once again, we can say that the boiling point is a physical property that depends upon molar mass. As the molar mass of the compounds increases, the boiling points of the compounds also increases. And secondly, for the given same molecular formula or for the given isomers, whenever the branches are going to get increased, the boiling points are going to get a decrease, right? One more example. See here, one more example from the textbook. Once again, I'm going to share the textbook. Yes, on the screen. On the screen, read the B, small b. In the same question, read the small b. Here, small b. Pentane-1-ol, N-butane, pentanol, ethoxy-ethane. Once again, the first one is pentane-1-ol, second one is N-butane, third one is pentanol, fourth one, ethoxy-ethane. Among these compounds, which is going to have less boiling points and which one is going to have high boiling points, right? Yes, once again, I'm going to share the screen. For that question, here is the answer. So the compounds given are, what are the compounds given? The first compound given is pentane-1-ol. Pentane-1-ol, CH3, CH2, 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 OH. Second compound is N-butane, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Third compound given is pentanol, all means CH3, CH2, 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 all. All is indicating aldehyde. C double bond was single bond H, pentanol. And the last compound is ethoxy-ethane. Ethoxy means CH3, CH2, O. This group, ethoxy group with ethane. Ethane means CH2, CH3 with single bond. This is the ethane. So this total compound is named as ethoxy-ethane. So all these are the four compounds given. Right, now you have to guess. Among all these compounds, which is going to have high boiling points? And what is the reason? Can anybody guess the reason? Among these compounds, among the four compounds, which is going to have high boiling points? Yes, the alcohols are going to have. Once again, alcohols are going to have high boiling point. Sushma, it is not the pentanol. Pentanol, see here. Once again, see here. Pentanol is containing which group? C double bond O, single bond H group. Double bond O means here, to this oxygen, there is no hydrogen is bonded. In the aldehyde, to the oxygen, there is no hydrogen is bonded. So this oxygen is not going to form the hydrogen bonding easily. This oxygen is not going to form the hydrogen bond easily. Which oxygen is going to form the hydrogen bond easily? Yes, alcohol oxygen. Because the alcohol oxygen, OH group is there, the alcohol oxygen is bonded with hydrogen. I'm going to write on the board. Yes, the compounds given are pentane-1-ol. Pentane-1-ol is written as CH3, single bond, CH2, single bond, CH2, single bond, CH2, single bond, O, single bond, H, oxygen with partial negative charge, hydrogen with partial positive charge. So whenever in a compound, oxygen with partial negative charge, bonded with hydrogen with partial positive charge, that compounds are able to form intermolecular hydrogen bondings. So this is a compound readily forms intermolecular hydrogen bonding, and it is an alcohol. First of all, this is an alcohol. So alcohols are readily forming intermolecular hydrogen bondings. Hence, they are going to have high boiling points. So among the given four compounds, pentane 1-ol is going to have the high boiling point, right? Next one is the pentanol. What is the pentanol? Pentanol is written as CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH2 single bond, C double bond, O single bond, H. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons are there in the pentanol. And the third compound given is, what is the third compound given? What is the third compound given? Yes, the third compound given is ethoxy ethane is written as CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond, O single bond, CH2 single bond, CH3. And the last one, N butane is CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH3. Among these four compounds, yes, see here, once again, see here, the four compounds given is pentane 1-ol is CH3, CH2, 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 OH. Pentanol is CH3, CH2, 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 C double bond, O single bond, H. Ethoxy ethane is CH3, CH2, single bond, O single bond, CH2, single bond, CH3. N butane is CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Yes, text me, among all these four compounds, which one is having the lower molecular mass? Which one is going to have the lower molecular mass? Text me your answer. Which one is going to have the low molecular mass? Very simple. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons are present here. Whereas here, 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons are present with oxygen. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons are present. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbons with oxygen is present. Sorry, 5 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, it is a pentanol. Pentanol means CH2 single bond OH. Oxygen with partial negative charge, hydrogen with partial positive charge. Once again, pentanol means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. So among all these one, N-butane is having the low molecular mass. Hence, it is going to have low boiling point. So what is going to have low boiling point? N-butane is going to have the low boiling point because of the low molecular mass. And pentane 1-ol being an alcohol, it is able to form intermolecular hydrogen bondings. It is able to form intermolecular hydrogen bondings. So this is going to have high boiling point. So among the four compounds, compound number 1, compound number 2, compound number 3, and compound number 4. Compound number 4 is having low boiling point. Compound number 1 is having high boiling point. Okay, it is very clear. Alcohols are having high boiling point due to ability to form intermolecular hydrogen bondings. Right, now the question will arise. Among the pentanol and ethoxy ethane. Yes, can anybody guess? Which is going to have less boiling points? Actually, this is the ether. And it is the aldehyde. Once again, pentanol is the aldehyde. C double bond, O single bond, H is present in the pentanol. Okay? Whereas in the ethoxy ethane, is the ether. Single bond, O single bond group is present. And it is a symmetrical ether. And this oxygen is having neither partial negative charge nor partial positive charge because of symmetry of ethyl group and ethyl group. Once again, here this oxygen is not going to have either partial positive charge or partial negative charge. So whenever the partial positive and partial negative charges can be formed, that will going to be bonded with another molecule easily. Then the boiling point will get increased. But in the case of ethers, ethoxy ethane, it is not happening. Hence, ethoxyethane is going to have less boiling point with compared to pentanol. So finally, which one is having the high boiling point means pentane one all. Next one is pentanol. Next one is ethoxyethane, and the last one is N-butane. Right? Take the screenshot. So simply, we can conclude that the boiling points of the compounds depends upon the molecular mass. As the molecular mass increases, the boiling points get increases. Of course, if the compound is able to form intermolecular hydrogen bondings, such compounds are also going to have high boiling points, right? This is about boiling points. As time is very less, in the next class, we will discuss about solubility of alcohols, phenols, and ethers. Thank you for watching my video lectures. Please read the same content from the NCERT textbook and try to solve the MCQs. If you are having any doubt, you can call me. Don't text. Don't text, please. Because so many WhatsApp groups are there. Please call me. We will discuss your doubts. Thank you one and all. This is your chemistry lecturer, Sesdar Naidu, signing off. Have a nice day. Please send me the attendance screenshots. Thank you. Thank you one and all.